और दूसरी तरफ अगर हम देखें तो लगातार मुंहतोड़ जवाब दिया जा रहा है पाकिस्तान को, उन तमाम दुश्मनों को जो भारत माता की तरफ गंदी निगाहों से देखते हैं, छिन्न भिन्न करने की कोशिश करते हैं। और ऐसे में आज एक बड़ा आयोजन है जैसलमेर में, वायु शक्ति 2019 युद्धाभ्यास का आगाज हो चुका है। बीएस धनोवा इसके मुख्य अतिथि हैं।
In exercise Gagan Shakti, we showed the way we would fight. Today we display the way we would influence events on the ground. We are showcasing our ability to hit hard, hit fast, hit with precision, hit during day, hit during night, and hit under adverse weather conditions through our autonomous bombing capability. While showcasing our strike capability, we don't let our air defense guard down. Should the enemy choose to respond, we are displaying our ability to shoot him down through our airborne and ground-based air defense systems. While wars are fought few and far between, we have an ever-present sub-conventional threat, as the enemy knows he cannot defeat us in a conventional conflict. So today we showcase our ability to punish, our ability to insert and extricate troops from hostile territories. Ladies and gentlemen, close to 140 fighters, helicopters and transport aircraft operating from a variety of bases will take part in this event. My compliments to Air Marshal H.S. Arora, Air Officer Commanding in Chief, Southwestern Air Command, Air Officer Commanding Air Force Station Jaisalmer, and the entire team of air warriors from different commands who have put in their hearts and souls for success of today's demonstration. Finally, on behalf of the brave men and women of the IAF, I wish to assure the nation of IAF's capability and commitment in meeting national security challenges and defending the sovereignty of our country. IAF is ever prepared to deliver appropriate response as assigned by our political leadership and will always remain at the forefront in executing its missions. Indian Air Force will always serve with pride, honor, selflessness and dignity so that we can continue to touch the sky with glory. Our continued focus is to build and maintain an effective air force that is fully capable of securing the nation in peace and war. Jai Hind.
Ladies and gentlemen, marking the momentous occasion, those were the three Mi-17 V-5s of the Indian Air Force flying in big formation, trooping the Indian Air Force ensign and the Southwestern Air Command ensign. The Indian Air Force's vision envisages optimal and effective use of aerospace power to generate multiple options while addressing future security challenges. The application of aerospace power would particularly prove decisive in winning short and intense wars in future. The upgradation of existing fleets and induction of new platforms and weapon systems have enabled the Indian Air Force to tackle threats across the spectrum of conflict and project power in India's areas of interest. Indian Air Force's modernization plan has based its growth on self-reliance to bolster the Indian Air Force's strategic reach capability. Ladies and gentlemen, Air Officer Commanding in Chief, Southwestern Air Command, Air Marshal H.S. Arora, Ati Vishisht Seva Medal, shall now take permission from the Chief of the Air Staff to commence the Vayu Shakti 2019 display.
Sir, may I have permission to start exercise Vayu Shakti 2019? Thank you, sir.
And now, ladies and gentlemen, here comes a deep strike Jaguar aircraft equipped with an imaging pod that shall click our pictures at the grandstand. A big round of applause, ladies and gentlemen. Wing Commander DJ Singh would now be briefing the Chief of the Air Staff on the layout of the daytime targets. Please pay close attention to the screens and get ready to know the enemy.
Jai Hind, sir. I am Wing Commander TJ Singh and I shall now brief you regarding the day targets which are laid out in general clock codes of 10 o'clock to 2 o'clock at a distance of 1 to 3 kilometers from us. The targets are labeled in a sequence of 1 to 16 and they shall be engaged in that same numerical sequence. All the targets are representing actual enemy assets which would be well dispersed in the battlefield. However, for ease of viewing and demonstration purposes, we have grouped them and placed them close to each other. I shall now be describing all the targets from our left to right. At the extreme left is target number 3, which depicts a runway at the enemy's airfield. Further, we have target number 14, which depicts a tank convoy. In the same line, further in the distance, is target number 7, which represents an enemy command and control center. Moving right, we have target number 11, which represents a POL dump. Further right and in the distance is target number 15, which represents an enemy troop concentration. Moving further right and closer to us is target number 2, which depicts an enemy radar. In the same line, further up in the distance is target number 10, which depicts a logistics node. Moving further in the center, we have target number 16, which represents an enemy camp. In the same line, further up is target number 13, which depicts an operations room. Further right and closer to us is target number 1, which depicts a radar site. Further right and in the distance is target number 6, which represents a weapons storage area. Further right and closer to us is target number 9, which represents an advanced mounting area of the enemy's army. Moving right and closer to us is target 12, which represents a vehicle convoy. Further right and in the distance is target number 5, which represents the launch site of the enemy's tactical surface-to-surface missile. Moving right and closer to us is target number 4, which represents a bulk petroleum installation. And at the extreme right is target number 8, which represents an enemy bunker. All the targets today would be hit by iron bombs, which fall freely under the effect of gravity, or precision-guided bombs, or air-to-ground rockets of various caliber, or gun ammunition. Simulated aerial targets would be engaged with air-to-air missiles. Our pilots would be delivering their weapons in three modes of attack, which are the dive attack, the lay-down attack, and the medium altitude level release. A dive attack would be performed by the pilot by placing the aircraft into a sharp descent towards the target so as to aim the weapons accurately. Such an attack is preferred against targets which have hardened structure and reinforced surfaces. A lay-down attack is performed by flying the aircraft at ultra-low levels at high speeds so as to delay or deny visual as well as radar pickup by the enemy. Such an attack is preferred against targets which have linear extent, such as runways and bridges. A medium or a high-altitude level release is performed by flying the aircraft high away from the ground so as to remain clear of the enemy's surface-to-air guided weapons. Such an attack is preferred for area bombing and delivery of precision-guided munitions. In addition to these, we shall be witnessing special forces operations and certain peacetime missions which the Indian Air Force performs readily in the service of the nation. With that, sir, I've come to the end of my brief.
Thank you.
Thank you, sir. Jai Hind.
Mananiya Atithigan, अगला प्रदर्शन एक MiG-29 विमान का है जो कि आपके बाएं से दाएं की ओर आवाज की गति से भी तीव्र 1300 किलोमीटर प्रति घंटे की रफ्तार से गुजरेगा. लेडीज एंड जेंटलमैन, एरियो वॉरफेयर इज सिनोनिमस विद प्रिसिशन, पावर एंड मोस्ट ऑफ ऑल स्पीड. टू शोकेस दीज यूनिक क्वालिटीज ऑफ एन एरियल अटैक, We will commence today's demonstration with a MiG-29 aircraft flying past faster than the speed of sound at 1300 kilometers per hour. What this means is that this aircraft will reach us even before the sound that it is making can get to us, making it seem as if it were moving in absolute silence till the time it crosses us. After it crosses, you will hear the so-called sonic boom, which will seem like a loud explosion followed by the noise of the aircraft's jet engines. Ladies and gentlemen, please strain your eyes towards the left. The MiG-29 is now in view. It will have no sound. Tune into the silence.
Please look straight at